celebrating those who take pride in their city. The annual Keep Dunedin Beautiful Awards have been held to acknowledge the hard work that residents do to ensure Dunedin looks its best. This year, around 50 accolades have been given out to a range of groups and individuals.
So we're really wanting to recognise people that are making an effort in some kind of way, whether it's big or small, to beautify the city or encourage civic pride or kind of all those little and big activities that make the city a nicer place for people to live.
A smaller number than usual attended the awards this year due to it being a short week with two public holidays. But it made little difference, with plenty of applause when Mayor Dave Cull presented one of the top prizes to six-year-old Ashton Heptonstall. He was inspired to clean sites around the peninsula after seeing a dead seagull with a fish hook in its mouth.
Basically clean up beaches, basically mostly roads. I usually find plastic cups and bags.
Several classroom-based groups also won awards, including St Hilda's Collegiate and Portobello School. But it was the Dunedin Amenities Society that took home the other coveted first place award.
It's a fantastic award and really good recognition for the society. Town Belt Traverse is a fantastic event. I think the other thing too is that the Project Gold project, which we've kicked off last year with Otago Girls High School, the idea of bringing back Kowai into the Town Belt was just awesome.
The society is now planning for its next Traverse later in the year. Award organisers also took the time to honour former Keep Dunedin Beautiful coordinator Darlene Thompson. The Campus Watch and City Rise Up groups received the second and third place awards respectively. Ruby McAndrew, 39, Dunedin News.